Hi, how are you doing? Is school out now or almost out?
Almost.
Almost. Are you looking forward to that? Yeah, whole summer. Let's see what I have in this paper. What was that?
A lion.
This lion is about 100 years old. It's a lion bank and it's been in my wife's family all this time. And we put money in there and everything. So, yes?
One day I went to the zoo and there was a polar bear out there when he died.
Oh.
Polar bears aren't my favorite.
Yeah, they're beautiful animals. And lion is a beautiful animal. And you know that in the Bible, lions are mentioned over 100 times. So,
what's the top for?
The top is where you put money in.
How do you get the money out?
There's the screw here. You have to take a screwdriver and open it up. And then it comes in 2 bucks. Anyway, many times in the Bible, the lion is depicted. Is shown as a strong, noble animal. In fact, Jesus was born into the house or the tribe of Judah. And Judah is symbolized by a lion because of its strength and its power. Yes?
Lions were way back in the old years.
Well, you know that lions in the Bible are also shown as being mean and vicious. You know, you have to be careful of them. And well, let me talk about this.
Yeah, they have sharp teeth.
They have sharp teeth. That's why you have to be careful. Yes.
And they will eat you.
That is true. And I read there what Saint Peter said in his reading. He said, "Be sober-minded." Sober-minded means clear thinking. Be watchful. Your adversary is a big word. It means your enemy. Is the devil prowls, creeps around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. Devour means to eat. So the devil is like a lion wanting to eat you. Now, you are all Christians, right?
Yeah.
I'm a Christian, pastor. My parents are. Do we? I'm going to ask you a question, but I don't want you to answer it, okay? Just think about it for a few seconds. Are we as Christians to be afraid and worried about the devil?
No.
Don't give me an answer. Let me answer it this way. One of my wife's and one of our favorite places to go on a little vacation is down 100 miles south of here to the Monterey Bay Area, Monterey, Pacific Grove, Carmel, cities that have nice old houses, a lot of history, buildings that are 200 years old, and a beautiful coastline where the ocean comes in. Now, we were there a few weeks ago for 3 days, and we went to a place called Carmel River Beach and Park, the state park. And there's a sign as you walk towards the beach and he says, "Man, listen, I'm going to tell you a story, okay?" There's a sign as you head toward the beach. I should have taken a picture of it, but I kind of remember what it all said. And it said, "Warning, ocean warning." And it said, "Beware of rip currents and undertows."
What?
Beware means be careful. Be really careful. Beware. Okay. like the line, you beware. And it said, keep your eyes on the waves, for there are sleeper waves. Well, sleeper wave is, you know, the waves come in, they go out, come in, come out. And they seem to be always pretty close to each other. But once in a great while, there's a wave that goes like this. Way much farther. That's a sleeper or rogue wave, it's called. And then another rule, it says, never turn your back to the ocean.
Oh, look it.
Why?
Because the real reason is that they're a rogue wave.
Yeah.
And I think that the crazy reason is that a giant shark can pop out of the water.
Like your dolphin can pop their boat.
Okay, and there's one more. It said, don't play ocean tag. That's what my sons used to do. The waves come in, you know, wave comes in, then it rolls out, it rolls in,
oh, rolls
out. And then my boys would run out like this, would run out to where the wave was, and they say, nah, 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 you can't get me. And then the next wave comes in, then they back up, and they said, it didn't get me. And then the wave went back, and then they go again, nah, nah, you can't get me. So that's ocean tag. I said, don't do that, especially where it's really dangerous. Now, those are all danger things. But let's say I'm on a high hill, 40, 50 feet away from the ocean, but I see the ocean. Do I have to be afraid of undertows? Do I have to be afraid of these sleeper waves? Do I have to?
Might be if they're large enough.
Not if I'm 50 feet up there. So I don't have to be afraid.
Now,
what I want to answer this question, or do we have to be afraid of the devil? If you and I are with Jesus, and we're with him all the time, we don't have to be afraid of the devil. But if we're going to play games with the devil, like ocean tag, I mean, say, well, I love Jesus, but I'm going to, maybe I'll tell some lies sometimes. Sometimes I will not pick good friends. That's, you know, that's okay. So, or I don't always have to want to go to church or something like that. That's playing games with the devil. And we don't want to do that. That's what St. Peter is saying. Be watchful. Be careful. But if we're with Jesus, the devil can't get us. He can cause us little problems, but he can't grab us. He can't eat us. He can't, like the lion would eat us. The devil can't take us away from Jesus. And that's wonderful news, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, let's keep that in mind and pray. Dear Father, thank you for Jesus, and may we always be with Jesus all our life long, and today, and forever. Amen.
We continue with the singing of the next hymn.